I want my legacy to be music that outlasted me, my kids, my kids' kids. I want to do the kind of music that you can listen to 20 years from now, and it rocks just as hard as it did 20 years prior. You know, when I leave this plane of existence, I want people to say, that kid Neyo did real music. Timeless music.
Sinister! We got the minister. I'm the so spectacular.
Wallace.
I'm the Everybody want to know not the dreadlocks. Globally, them a talk about dreadlocks. All me can tell them a real not the dreadlocks. Not about commercial dreadlocks. Use of the future, give them what them lack. Them want pro tool, then with each back. So I link them with not the dreadlock. Now them a sign $1 million contract. Everybody tune in to the dreadlock show. Number one show. Tune in to the Fredlock Show, number one show. Spectaculous, I am giving you a reference. Fredlock Show is a show with a difference. Talent are the thing, money not get preference. Broadcast get a youths without a sense. Fredlock Show gone globally, international not locally. Fredlocks never wait for nobody. Reggae embassy, that's so am I daddy. Fredlock Show is a beat them badly. Play reggae music sweeter than candy. Give your eye like a mountain peak. Fredlock Show never miss me a week. Everybody tune in to the Fredlock Show, number one show. Tune in to the Fredlock Show, number one show.
Take a walk with me, bro. It's kind of interesting, because this is the intersection of going on the road. The number 5 train. One of my favorite spots right here in the world. See? Some things are going on, as you know. Mr. Mandela died, and George Mann is going to meet us. You know, we think about the effort, you know, to maintain himself while we were incarcerated. That makes the news from being president.
There's a few things that I try to do with every song that I make. I try to make sure that I write about something relatable, you know. I've always viewed myself as a regular person, so I write from the standpoint of a regular person. You know, so my music relates to regular people, everyday people. Try to find a melody that's catchy enough to where you hear it once or twice and you can sing it back. The hook to your song is the most important part of your song. Verses are important too, but the hook is the part that people are supposed to remember. So you got to make sure that your hook is simple enough to where somebody's going to remember it, yet not so simple that it's stupid. You know what I mean? Like, well, I ain't going to get no examples right now. I'm calling nobody out. But you know what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying. So those are the things that I try to do with all my music. Biggest business lesson I've learned. Just living life, making mistakes, and you know, learning from them. Scared money don't make none. That's for damn certain. You know, and just learning the business that you're in. You know, a lot of people, you think about the music industry, and all you really think about is, especially, you know, cats that want to get in the music business, you don't think about the business side of it. All you focus on is the music, and I want to get on stage and perform in front of a bunch of people, and blah, 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 blah. But what you don't understand is that this is a business, okay? There's the music side of it, and there's the business side of it. And the business side of it is a major, major part of it. And if you don't know nothing about it, there are snakes in the grass, and you will get bit. That's just the reality of it. So learn the business that you are in, all aspects of it. I think it's pressure on any celebrity to be a role model. I mean, we're in the public eye, and you know, we've been given a bigger microphone than the average man. So, you know, yes, it's kind of our responsibility to in a way lead by example. You know, I mean, that's not to say that you can't have your own life. You can definitely have your own life, but you need to understand that these kids are watching what you're doing. Even more so than maybe their parents or their teachers or the people that you would want them to look up to. Nah, they're looking at y'all. They're looking at us. You know, looking at what we're doing, and they want to be what we are. They want to copy what we're doing. So, you know, it would be in your best interest to and just to be aware of that and just, you know, be careful with
it. This kid, baby, is a jerk. Remember, you good. This is Zhavea.
I'm here live at Sequoia Middle School, and I have one of the most talented young artists. I don't know if some of you know about her, but she's very good.
My name is Zhavea. My new single is called Ten Up. It's available on iTunes.
Oh, okay.
We also have a dance mix version, which you can find on YouTube.
Oh, okay.
And basically, we just did the show, and it was really fun. I love singing. Okay. That's just what I love to do all the time. I was nervous.
Yeah.
I was nervous. Oh, I'm not going to lie. I was nervous, but it was a great opportunity. I just like to thank him for giving me this opportunity.
Certainly, he's a great guy.
Yeah. You know, a lot of people just tell you something, they're going to do it, and they don't end up doing it, and they're not real, the real deal. But, you know, I've learned from my mistakes, and now I'm starting to, you know who's real, who's not, you know, who can help me, who can't help me. So,
okay, good, good.
Yeah.
Well, listen, guys, it's just as challenging for me as it is her, you know? I'm standing right next to a very beautiful and talented young lady.
Oh, thank you.
Okay? And so she's going to help me make my show hot. So you stick with me. Stick with the Fredlock Show, and we'll be right back. I have a very interesting person that's sitting beside me. She is the mother of that beautiful, talented young artist that we just saw. And let me tell you something, folks. This is why I like what I do. You know, I get a chance to be with a lot of beautiful women. But on a serious tip, you know, I want to speak to you about, you know, some of the challenges that you've had just being a mom, having your daughter on the road, you know.
Basically, this is her only shot, you know, at this age.
Okay.
So I want to set a good foundation for her. We come across a lot of challenging with people in the industry that just not on the up and up. So I want to be here for her to make sure that, you know, she's guided right, she's educated in the industry right, and not trying to get too ahead too fast without knowing what she's getting into. It's better to go slow and do it right than rush into it and then make a lot of mistakes. So one of the biggest things is that people always say, oh, that's not her hair, she has a weave and all of that, and
wow,
every strand of that is in her head is her hair. So yeah, it was ridiculous, but you know, she's like, after a while, she's like, whatever, I don't care, I know it's, you know. So just little things like that, you know, you have to learn how to deal with that and just get over and move on
and
forget about it and just do what you need to do.
Well,
to...
just stop it, okay? She's very pretty. She's very talented. You understand? Just stop it. I don't want anybody saying anything about my young artist, okay?
There's a lot of you running around out there claiming to be fighters. Many of you don't even know how to throw a punch. Now, it's very important to understand that to make a punch, the key to the punch is this finger. Here. That finger keeps that finger from moving. Very important, this finger right here. Okay? Pull the fingers in here. And you have a fist. Most of you guys are used to making it like this. That was the old way. We've improved it.
Don't keep that finger straight out. Right there. It has to be straight out. Okay? And then this finger just locks it. And it keeps it tight. Okay? That's the fist. Here. Correct. Here.
Power's in the head.
Okay?
What happens a lot of times is you guys hold your fist the regular way, and when you punch somebody, you walk around and your fist relaxes, and you know, you hit somebody and you hit your hand. You have to mess up your hand because it's not tight. So you have to make this tight. Tight. Strong. Okay. Then you have the delivery. This comes from here. This goes out. This young man was born the third child of Rita and the great legendary Bob Marley. Last time I checked, he's a Grammy Award winner. I think he's got about five of them. Here is Stephen Marley. Check it out.
First of all, you know, I come from a movement. You know what I mean? You can't really pick me out. Because what I do is still from a movement, you know? It's from a family of music where my record is a result of family efforts still, you know? Right, so there's more like me. Yeah, that's what I was, there are more like me. How important was my father? Very important. I mean, he was one of, you know, the carriers of the baton. You know what I mean? Help pave the way for us to be here today on the 16th floor of this building talking about reggae. Overall, you know, we feel him spirit. You know what I mean? And that's a good thing. If we don't feel it, we ain't gonna do it. Because you see music so close to each other. Parallel, you know what I mean? You check the same flamenco, you go Brazil, you hear it, you go Africa. You hear the same type of guitar in when you say, wait, isn't that a Spanish? No, that's African, yeah, that's Brazilian, that's... So, that you know, because music so parallel and we are fans of music, all music influence. Music is balanced, you know what I mean? There's something in there for everyone. Reggae is the foundation, you know what I mean? Reggae is where I'm from, yeah, but the world is where I'm going. We abandon the government. We abandon government. Rastafari is the government. Christ said he shall return in a new name. You know what I mean? And this time he not come as no lamb to the slaughter, but as the King of Kings. Yeah, and His Majesty is that man. His that person in this time is Christ, in his kingly character. You know? Yeah, that's what we see. Our father wrote the first song for us. Actually, the first two songs. A song called Children Playing in the Street, when something like this. Children playing in the streets. Da-da-da-da-da. Unbroken bottles on rubbish heap. Another little baby got nothing to eat. Yeah. So that was the first song, you know?
What was the second?
Second song was a song called Trodding. Trodding in Jerusalem just like Janai. Trodding in Jerusalem just like Janai. Yeah. Music, business-wise, you kind of follow the same steps, yes? But, you know, music will speak for itself.
Big up to my good love. Big up to yourself. Now, you guys know I can't be here. Just too very grateful to be. But I got something for you. This is Neyo. Oh yeah, Michael's new. You don't do it.
This is your host, Magic Love, with Tanay Jackson. Tanay, you're related to the Jacksons, right?
Correct.
And who is your dad?
Tito.
Tito Jackson. It's sad, but we send out, we lost a big icon. And after we lost Michael, it did a lot of damage to the world and the industry. What do you think about what happened?
Well, firstly, when Michael died, I was actually vacationing in the Hamptons, and you know, people were calling me. I wasn't even watching TV. They were calling me. They were like, you know, I heard. I'm so sorry. I said, you're sorry about what? And they said, is it true that Michael died? And I said, no, it's not true, because you know, people say all kinds of stuff. So I turned on the television and I saw CNN and. I saw Jermaine come out and I saw his face and I said, oh God, it's true. When I left the Hamptons, I couldn't do anything. I would go to sleep, I'd wake up and I would just be depressed because I know there's no more Michael. It really, really hurt because you know, I have a few issues with my family, and you know, he was the only person in the family that you know, treated me so well. He was the kindest person I actually knew. He made me feel comfortable. When you are a big celebrity, people are going to come to you. They're going to come to you negatively and positively because you stand out. You're at the top, and it's lonely at the top. There is no one like you, so there'll always be people trying to reach and grab at you, and that's what was happening with Michael. That's what comes along with what he, you know, with his career.
What's your memories, and what is it that you want the world to really know?
Well, he was a humanitarian. What a lot of people, you know, wasn't mentioning is the billions of dollars that he gave away to charities to help children. No one ever spoke about that. He was very generous and very kind, and not all the time he got that love back.
What do you remember of Michael, and the last time you talked to him, what was it?
The last time I spoke to Michael, I was in California. And I was on the phone with one of my other uncles, I believe it was Randy, and I said, you know, can you please ask Michael if I'm still his angel? And he put Michael on the phone. I said, am I still your angel? He said, well, you know, you're your father's angel first, but of course you're my angel. And that was the last thing.
Was he very shy?
I guess he was shy when he was younger. I didn't, you know, I don't, when I was around him, I didn't find him to be that shy.
Okay, he's probably comfortable with you. You know, you are his niece. And today I want to ask you, what are your goals now? What is it that you are trying to do? Are you out there?
Well, you have to have tough skin for this industry. You can't let every little thing bother you. You're supposed to let every negative thing that comes at you gear you to go forward. If you have raw talent,
You know, don't have a big head. Still go and get training. Still go and get a, you know, trained for your craft. If you're a dancer and you're a great dancer and everyone loves you, that's nice. Still go and get some training so that you can broaden and expand your craft. Okay? Don't be a big head about it. That's one thing you should do.
Stay humble.
This industry is dangerous and it's very, very hard. You have to have someone, you know, by your side, protecting you at all times. The minute that person turns their head, you can get caught and grabbed up.
You get caught up. I know you said you adopt children. You adopted some children.
I didn't adopt them. I fostered them. I always dreamt of being a parent. There are girls out there younger than me who are parents. People think I'm crazy for doing that, but I felt that I can raise a child and teach them some of the things that I know. Because I was very fortunate in life. I learned a lot at a young age, and I had a lot at a young age. And you
know, is school very important?
School is most important. If you don't have school, you better have a lot of money. Because if you don't have a lot of money, you're going to need the education. And that's that.
That's right. That's right. School and education, wisdom, knowledge.
Well, I mean, music and entertainment is all I know. That's the first thing I've done was dance. That's saying that it's rough in the industry. But, I mean, every industry has its ups and downs. Now, it's like telling Tiger Woods, there's ups and downs in golf. Why should you golf? That's what he was born to do. And that's what
he was born to do that.
There you go. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmony of liberty. Let our rejoicing arise high as the listening sky. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Yeah.
That's hot. Tanay Jackson, right there, Industry 101, bringing you real, real, real talent.
I'm here with a very popular, very famous, very brilliant artist, and it's Shaggy. You know, I've seen him quite a number of times, but you know something? Every time I see him, you know, it makes me feel the same way. He's funny, he's intelligent, he's smart. You know, I'm going to let him tell you a few things about himself. Once again, for those who may not know him. Are you kidding? Mr. Lover. How you doing, sir?
Bless, man.
Bless. I was talking to some folks, and they were telling me that you were in the military. And I wanted to kind of know, you know, how was that experience? And what do you think about, you know, your time that you did there? And, you know, what are your feelings about that?
Well, the military is one of them things where you go through, you know. Yeah. As a younger youth in Flatbush, you know, kind of hanging with the wrong crowd and going the wrong direction. The military, mm-hmm. to me, was a way out, you know?
Oh, okay.
And kind of went into it just to kind of get rid of the elements then when we were around, you know what I mean? And I mean, I was no model Marine, you know what I mean? I went there, I did 4 years and came out at PFC, so.
Oh, okay.
He's a boy, I did get trouble, you know?
Oh.
But, you know, I used to drive down from North Carolina to New York every weekend just to do music, you know what I mean?
Okay.
And, you know what I mean? It was an 18-hour drive round trip. You know what I mean? I'm a matter of fact, I voice old Caroline and big up in my uniform. So, you know what I mean? It's just a love of music keeping me come back.
Oh, okay.
Well, I was doing music before.
Good.
Dance, but music wasn't paying my bills. So,
oh, okay.
It was reggae music at that time. You know, there wasn't much success in reggae music.
Right,
so, that's
right.
Why.
So, once again, stick in tune to the Friend Lock Show, and we'll be right back.
Yeah,
thank you.
Salud.
Put your hands up, my people, throw your hands up, you throw your hands up, you throw your hands up, you throw your hands up, now scream! Yo, hold on, I'm feeling the party, you feel the party?
Yes.
Is the party attraction right now?
Yes.
Is it? Is the party right here? You feel the party, son? If you get caught with your hand in the cookie jar, you say, put your hands in the air.
Honey, give me that, she's coming up and get me
Once again, we're backstage live. This is where everything happens. It's at the Sequoia Middle School. That's all the way out here in Long Island. We had to take a trip out here. Anyway, I ran into some young folks who was signed to Shaggy's label. So introduce yourselves and...
Yeah, man, you don't know, say RSNY. Young Jugs. Boom, the jungle god. You don't know. Mad.
Yeah. Go by the name of Jugs ZB from RSNY.
New York City boy, but I'm Cali High, also known as the Heartbreak Kid. Big up Remix.
Yeah, man. Remix, he couldn't make it tonight, but I'm the next brother. I'm there right there, sir.
Yeah. We said the girl them love we long time. You know, said them they pan we side.
They pan we side.
Holla that champagne popping and everybody loving the vibe.
Loving the vibe.
Hey, roll up a couple dozen spliff with that big body girl by my side.
Girl by my side.
Nothing to do for the night. Come party with RSNY. Fill the cup, turn the party up. Ooh. Roll it up, make it go sparky up. Yeah. Fill the cup, turn the party up. Roll it up, make it go sparky up. Ah, yeah. Fred Locks, big up yourself for RSNY. Boom, Ranchi and T, best dressing.
Thank you so much, guys, and I appreciate it. And much success, much love. You understand me? That's all it don't. All right.
Till next time, I get.
Big up.
Straight up, this love is like a blessing from above. Baby girl, you know we go together like hand in glove. Cause girl, I'm always glad to see you. Say this is Shaggy and Neyo.
I'm loving as you, girl, you, girl. Sunshine and the flowers, jealous of the power of you, girl, you, girl. Reason in my heartbeat, we hit the bed but no sleep, ooh, girl.
Right before the lights up, put on the pleasure when nobody is calling, and make our face light up. Me get the ratings from just how me performing. She know I got the right touch, and she no stop request me daily. My one and only lady, cause lately she know, sir, I understand the body language you're speaking, that physical attraction, the little things you do, your temperature peaking. I'm loving your dimensions. They put together now for me to revealing. You captured my attention. Cause girl, you got the real thing that on my bending knee thing. My feelings are so sure.
I know it's you, girl, you, girl. Sunshine and the flowers, jealous of the power of you, girl, you, girl. Reason in my heartbeat, we hit the bed, but no sleep, ooh, girl.